what are you going to do on here?
Is going to CIA headquarters.
Let's do this game.
Let's do this. Enough to deal with Mulder as just sort of just beginning as a stab, would you say?
Well, it's a great first move. I think we have to set a little back. Selecting Mike Pompeo as the next director of the CIA is a great move. I think having Senator Coates from Indiana as the director of national intelligence is another good move. And making this almost his first official act is important.
Yesterday is going to help have the new Secretary of HHS deal with that.
Well, and we
we know Congressman Price, nominee for HHS, has a lot of ideas about what he'll do when he gets there. Congressman Hurd, we appreciate your time as always, sir.
We appreciate you. Thanks for
Thanks
coming.
Again, fair and balanced now to Liz.
That's right. Let's continue our conversation about an executive order using the federal requirements of the individual mandate of the Affordable Care Act. Congressman John Garamendi is a former California insurance commissioner. He's been a strong supporter of the health care law. Congressman, thank you so much for joining us.
Good to be with you.
I know.
An exciting day. A lot of noise in this field.
We have some background noise behind us that folks at home may not be able to hear, and we're going to talk about that noise.
Sure.
But before we do, if I may, get your response from Congressman Hurd. He had talked about those premiums going up in his home state of California, about 34%. Your home state of California in 2017, they were up about 13%. I want to hear your reaction last night when you first heard of the executive order, one of the first things that President Trump signed.
Mostly window dressing. There's no real high impact. Eventually,